of all, I want to welcome all of you to our City Hall courtyard here. And we're blessed. If you recall last year, I think there was the chaplains and maybe three of us all here because of COVID. And look how God has blessed us. We can be back together. Those great people at CDC, and that's what I'm going to call them today, said that we could actually be outside without our masks. They also said that we can look each other in the eye again and see our smiles. So that makes a big difference. But there's a couple people here I want to introduce, and then I'm going to give this entire program over to our great chaplains, starting with Chaplain Peck. We have our Mayor Pro Tem, Philip Cothran. He is still after me. I'm sorry, this morning I messed up. Then we have Council Member John Roberts. Okay, our other council people, I didn't miss anyone. I see we have our Chamber President, Phil Cothran, is here. And we have our great Police Chief, Billy Green. Some people bring their fan club with them. You know, what's that all about? And we have all our chaplains over there. Raise your hand, gentlemen and ladies. I see we have Miss Fontana. And Janet, don't be hiding behind John Roberts. Our treasurer is here, Janet Kohler Brooks. And we even have some of our commissioners. Well, at least I see one that came over, Michael McGinnis. He's from our Park and Rec Commission. So he's spending the day with us, it looks like. We may have to feed that guy. And we, let's see, we have Garth Brooks. No, Garth. You know, I'm really afraid about today. We have Garth Nelson, our Community Services Director. And you guys are going to really choke me on this one, but our new city clerk is here. Our deputy city clerk, Ashton. There she is back there. Everybody get to meet her. That's who you can call and complain to. Okay? And I think I got everybody. See Daniel back there. Daniel Snyder is back there. And we thank the CAPON crew and all of our great staff members that helped put this together. So at this time, you know, you are always welcome when our city is doing something because you are our city. And to be able to pray together, it makes me super happy. So welcome to the city of Fontana, and please enjoy this prayer service. And now I will turn this entire program over to our chaplains who never stop praying for us.
I'm Chaplain Gregory Peck. Since 1775, when U.S. Congress called for national recognition of prayer, and it was recognized by Congress in 1952 to be the first Thursday in May. We've been celebrating this. Our theme scripture this year is 2 Corinthians 3:17. Now the Lord is the Spirit, and where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. How much do we need liberty today? Would you join me in prayer? Lord, we call on your Spirit to be here as we gather. We don't gather here to be on display, but as men and women who humbly invoke your blessings upon our city, our state, and our nation. In 2 Chronicles 7:14, it says, "If my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then I will hear from heaven and will forgive their sin and heal their land." Lord, help our nation be humble. Help us to be one nation under God, and help us turn from any wicked way and turn toward you and be blessed thereof. We ask this in Jesus' name. Amen. At this time, I want to introduce the Fontana Police Honor Guard, who will be presenting the colors today.
say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed as the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say, does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Remain standing as Councilman Philip Cawthron comes and leads us in our Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Heavenly Father, I just thank you for this glorious and beautiful day you have given us, Lord Jesus. Father, I pray for those that are military right now, Father. They're serving here in the United States and abroad in other countries, Father. Father, I pray for their safety, Lord. For those that are separated from their families, Lord, I pray for their families here, Lord, that you give them peace, Lord, to know that they'll be safe, Father. Father, I pray for the military, for the great effort and that they take to serve our country and protect us from any harm and evil, Father. Lord, I bring up the Joshua 1:9, Father, that says, have I not commanded you, be strong and of good courage. Do not be afraid nor dismayed, for the Lord your God is with you wherever you go. Thank you, Father, for being there with us, Lord, and with the military, Father. Señor, te doy gracias en este día porque podemos estar aquí juntos. Y sabemos que tú estás con nosotros. Estoy aquí para orar por la Fuerza Armada, Señor. Te pido que tú los protejas, Señor. Esos que están aquí en los Estados Unidos y en el mundo, Señor. Que tú protejas a su familia, Señor. Gracias, Señor. And Lord, I also pray for our fire department, Lord. For those that protect us every day, Lord, from fire, from harm, Lord. Father, I pray that you strengthen them, Lord. That you give them the courage to go out and fight the fires, Lord. I pray for them and their families, Father. Lord, we are so blessed to be able to have firemen that we can come at a moment's notice and protect us from any fires and harm, Father. I thank you, Lord, and I praise your name in this day. Amen.
These are the gates to the kingdom. These are the courts of the everlasting King. And we enter in with praise. We enter in with praise and thanksgiving. With praises on our lips, thanksgiving in our hearts, in loving worship of our Lord.
Let's bow. Father, Lord God, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for this great nation. We thank you for all of the people, all the men and the women who are part of the decision-making process. We just ask, Lord God, that you will guide their thoughts, their actions, and their reactions. We ask, God, that their steps are ordered by you. We ask, God, that you send a spirit of unity, oh God, that they can learn to work together for the best outcome for our nation. Our nation needs mature men and women who have the best interests of this nation at hand and who have an ear to hear what the Spirit of the Lord is saying. God, it's you and you alone who has the answer and the solution for all that we encounter and for all that we do, Lord God. God, today I just also pray for race relations. I know that the enemy's trick and scheme is to bring division. He comes to kill, to destroy, to separate. But Lord God, we are one nation, we are one people. The skin color, skin tone is irrelevant, Lord God. And we just ask that we get to a place in our nation where we look at the color, not look at the color, but the content of character. And Lord God, we focus on who we are better together. We are a better nation together. We're a better nation without the racial and all of the different things that people will try to use to leverage to separate us, God. We stand against that by the power and authority of God's Spirit. And we just ask, Lord God, that you begin to reveal and to let us know that we are better together and that we can work through this and that it is not about your skin color, where you come from, your economic status, or any of those things. It's about people who love each other, who care about each other, and that can be united. And today, on this National Day of Prayer, we just ask, God, that you release a spirit of unity in America, not just America, but around the world. And we pray all this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Blessed be the name of my rock, who trains my hands for war and causes me to walk in his overcoming power forevermore. Blessed be the name of my rock. Blessed be the name of my blessed be the Lamb who will open the scroll and loose the seven seals.
O God of unchangeable power and eternal light, we pray for your holy Catholic Church. Fill it with all truth, and in all truth with all peace. Where it is corrupt, purify it. Where it is in error, direct it. Where in anything it is amiss, reform it. Where it is right, strengthen it. Where it is in want, provide for it. Where it is divided, reunite it. Let the whole world see and know that things which were cast down are being raised up, and things which had grown old are being made new, and that all things are being brought to their perfection by him through whom all things were made, your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. O God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, our only Savior, the Prince of Peace, give us grace to take to heart the grave dangers we are in through our many divisions. Deliver your church from all enmity and prejudice and everything that hinders us from godly union. As there is one body and one spirit, one hope of our calling, one Lord, one faith, one baptism, one God and Father of us all, so make us all to be of one heart and of one mind, united in one holy bond of truth and peace, of faith and love, that with one voice we may give you praise through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Lord Jesus, you are the good shepherd who cares for his flock. We ask you to bestow upon your church the gifts of the Holy Spirit in abundance and to raise up from among us faithful and able persons called to the ministry. Inspire them to spend and be spent for the sake of the gospel and make them holy and loving servants and shepherds of the flock for whom you shed your most precious blood. Grant this for the sake of your love. Amen. And now we turn to those in the medical field who serve as doctors and nurses, as well as all those essential workers who work alongside them in the hospitals. Lord God Almighty, whose blessed Son came not to be served, but to serve, we ask you to bless all who, following in his steps, give themselves to the service of others, especially those in the medical field right now. Endue them with wisdom, patience, and courage, that they may strengthen the weak and raise up those who fall. And being inspired by your love, may worthily minister to the suffering, the friendless, and the needy, for the sake of him who laid down his life for us, your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Almighty God, whose blessed Son, Jesus Christ, went about doing good and healing all manner of sickness and disease among the peoples, continue in our hospitals this gracious work among us. Console and heal the sick. Grant to the physicians, nurses, and assisting staff wisdom and skill, diligence and patience. Prosper their work, O Lord, and send down your blessing upon all who serve the suffering. Heavenly Father, sustainer of our life and source of our hope, comfort and relieve all those who endure long-term illness and persistent handicap, especially those impacted by the devastating effects of COVID-19. Give your grace to all who minister to their needs, that they may be strengthened in their weakness and have confidence in your loving care. Through him who knows our weakness and has shared our sorrow, Jesus Christ our Lord. In your goodness, you created the earth and all its elements and have given us skills to make medicines and vaccines. Father, all healing ultimately comes from you, and in you we put our trust. Grant that these medications and vaccines may, in your mercy, give comfort and bring healing to our world. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
My grandfather made a statement at one time, and I didn't understand it. And the statement was, no one sharpens a knife unless they intend to use it. So all through my childhood and adulthood, that just kind of resonated. But as we started working with youth and teachers and educators, I found out that what we do is we try to sharpen our youth. But we have to be in a place where we're able to understand what we're doing. We have to be in a place where we're able to look at the youth and see who they can be, not who they are at that point in time. We have to look beyond their personality and look at their character. And it's our duty as educators to help them with their development. In some quick areas, help them with their size and growth by being a mentor. And a mentor is described as actions from a trusted and experienced advisor. So we have to be that advisor that they can trust. They have to look at us and say, this is something that I want to be like. This is someone that I want to pattern my life after. So we as educators have to understand what we are and what we need to do. And our life shows more than what we say. I know my children, when I would correct them, they would just stand there and say, mm-hmm, okay, and then watch what I do. We as educators are in a place where we have to live. I think the song is, we have to live the life we sing about in our songs. We have to be about our business. And we have to know that who we are, not by what we do. One question I ask youth is, number one, define the word respect without using the word respect. So I'm asking you, when you say respect me or I want to respect you, what are you really saying? If respecting someone means, for example, you respect me by looking me in my eyes when you're talking to me. So if you're not looking in my eyes, then you're not respecting me. So we have to know what that means. And lastly, I ask them to define themselves by who they are, not by what they do. So I say that to us here. Being a husband, being a father, being a wife, being a manager, these are all byproducts of who we actually are. Me, I'm consistent. Everything else that I do is from me being consistent. So once again, this is our prayer. No one sharpens a knife unless it's going to be used.
Oh Lord my God, when I in awesome wonder consider all the worlds thy hands have made, I see the stars, I hear the rolling thunder, thy power throughout the universe displayed. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. And when I think that God his Son not sparing sent him to die, I scarce can take it in that on the cross, my burden gladly bearing, he bled and died to take away my sin. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. When Christ shall come with shout of acclamation and take me home, what joy shall fill my heart. Then I shall bow in humble adoration and there proclaim, I, my God, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. How great thou art, how great thou art.
As I was seeking the Holy Spirit's guidance on what I should say here before you today, I began to think about the history of the National Day of Prayer. And it's been said earlier that this day was actually first instituted in 1775. What I didn't know that it was also rooted with another day of prayer. It's the day that we now know as Thanksgiving Day, Day of Thanksgiving. You see, the day of prayer in the spring was supposed to be, this day was supposed to be for prayer and for fasting. And then the Thanksgiving Day, the day of prayer in the fall was supposed to be to give thanks and praise. So we have 2 days, and these days are rooted closely together, the National Day of Prayer and our Thanksgiving holiday. And it's interesting that with these 2 days, there can be no mistaking that these United States were founded by godly men. I didn't say perfect men, I said godly men. These men understood the relationship between themselves and their Creator. These men and women who were with them, they knew very well the importance that acknowledging the providence of God would play in the building of this great nation. And although America stands poised as undoubtedly the greatest nation in the history of civilization, It would seem that a growing portion of the people of this nation have forgotten from whence their blessings come. And, you know, I'm truly humbled. I'm humbled to be here today to have this privilege of co-laboring with such a great group of godly men and women all throughout this plaza. You know, we come together today for the purpose of offering our collective prayers up to an almighty God. We come here today to cry out that God may have mercy on us. For without God's mercy, we would truly be men most miserable. And while every prayer here today is of utmost importance, no less than the same can be said about the prayer that I offer for a group of men and women who have made a sacrifice of themselves in order to serve the greater good of society. And in case you don't catch that, I'm talking about our brothers and sisters in law enforcement. They make a great sacrifice. And you see, a nation is only truly free when its citizens willingly conduct themselves within the bounds of the law. For without the law and without law enforcement, this notion of freedom would be nothing more than mere folly. And Romans chapter 12 says it this way. It says the following. It says that there is no authority but from God. And the authorities that exist are appointed by God. Therefore, whoever resists authority resists the very ordinance of God. And those who resist will bring judgment upon themselves. For authorities are not a terror to good works, but to evil. So if you want to be unafraid of authority, then do what's good, do what's right, do what's true, do what's pure, do what's honest, do what is of love, and you will receive the same. Now, I gotta tell you that my heart is endeared to law enforcement community. And many in law enforcement these days have been forced to take it on the chin. You know, a lot of good men and women have been unrighteously painted with a broad brush of condemnation by many factions of our society. When the wayward actions that enjoin them have actually only been perpetrated by but a few. And it is for this reason that I come before you today to offer the following prayer. Prayers for our men and women, our faithful men and women who serve us in law enforcement. I come to pray today for our law enforcement brothers and sisters' safety. Father God, I pray a hedge of protection around them, that no hurt, harm, or danger may befall them, that they may return home each and every day in the same manner that they left. But in addition to safety, I pray for their encouragement. I pray that they know that they are doing good and that they are loved and that they are appreciated by many more of us than not. But in addition to safety and encouragement, I also pray for wisdom. I pray for discernment. I pray that in this world of nanosecond split decisions that our officers can make the very best one for all parties concerned. And in addition to safety and encouragement and wisdom and discernment, I pray for compassion. I pray that our officers execute their duties with compassion. That as God's authority, that you are able, as God separates the sin from the sinner, you are able to separate the crime from the criminal. In order that we, not one of us standing here, has not been redeemed by our Maker, God. So let us seek to, therefore, attempt where we can to redeem those who have gone astray, that we may find value in every man and woman, dignity in every man and woman. But with compassion, I also pray for hope. I pray that as our officers advance along the timeline of their careers, that they are able to sustain the innocent optimism that marked their career's beginning, that they not become jaded and discouraged. I pray for faith. I pray that our law enforcement brethren and sistren have faith to call on their Creator in time of need. And I'm talking about Almighty God, a God who is so great, that when he sought to swear, he could find no one greater than himself. And he swore by himself, because there is none greater. And with the safety and the encouragement, with the wisdom, with the compassion and hope, with the faith that we pray for today, I pray for each and every officer's family. I pray for the covering of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, on the outside. I pray for the instilling, the indwelling, and the infusing of the Holy Spirit for each and every one of them on the inside, that God's peace, peace which surpasses all understanding, may be able to go before them as they go out and come in. It is these things that I pray for our law enforcement brothers and sisters. And what would make their jobs easier a lot of times is a strong economy. When we have jobs, when people can find the value and the dignity in working. For the Bible itself says, God has said that if a man doesn't work, neither should he eat. So we should all seek, as we are able, to go about our day finding something to put our hands to. Lord, bless my hands, but if I don't put my hands to something, I'm not giving God anything to bless. So we need jobs. So we pray for the economy today. We pray that in the midst, in the ashes of this post, and I'm speaking only partially prophetically because we're coming out of this thing, y'all. This post-pandemic season, that out of those ashes rises a new creation of jobs, good-paying jobs. Not jobs that are going overseas, but jobs that are staying here in America so that men and women can take care of their families. And Father, as I close this prayer, I close it with a portion of Psalms 138. And it reads thusly: though the Lord is great, he cares for the humble, but he keeps his distance from the proud. And though I am surrounded by troubles, yet you will protect me from the danger and the anger of my enemies. Lord, you reach out your hand, and the power of your right hand, it saves me. The Lord will work out all the plans for my life and for yours.
I want to pray for the businesses, the economy, and for the homeless situation. Join me in prayer. Lord, I pray for businesses here in Fontana, in our state, and our nation. I pray that you would open them up to where they can do business and they can be productive. Let the entrepreneurs be able to sell their products. And I pray that you would give wisdom to the leaders, wisdom to the business people, that they would do the right things, and help us to recognize that everything belongs to you. You own all the cattle on 1,000 hills. It all belongs to you. You just let us use it. I pray that you would bless these businesses, especially in our city, that they would flourish. And I pray for those who are less fortunate, those who are homeless, those for whatever reason, some because of alcohol, drugs, or mental illness, that you would meet their needs. Or those that just have hard times right now. I pray that you would help us to be like the Good Samaritan, to not pick and choose who we would help because of their stature, their race, or their creed, or anything else, but help us to reach out and help others because we're told to. And you told us that when we help one of these in need, we are helping you. To the least of these, my brethren, to them we reach out. And I pray that you would help us have compassion on those who are needy, those who are having hard times for whatever reason, that we'd reach out with a helping, loving, graceful hand. We ask this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Good morning, everybody. I have the honor this morning to be able to pray for our firefighters. So with your guys' hearts bowed, eyes closed, let's go before the Lord and just lift up our firefighters. Heavenly Father, Lord, we just come before you. We just ask, Lord, that, Lord, as we know the summer months are coming, Lord, they're right around the corner, Lord. We know that's where the highest of the fire start, Lord. And so I pray, Lord, for our firefighters here in Fontana, Lord. I lift them up to you, Lord. I know, Father, that you will be their shield. Lord, you will be their strength. So I pray for them, Lord, that through this time that they will just endure and that they will endure well, Lord. And Father, just bring the help that they need, you know, and just praying, Lord, that there will be no fires this summer, Lord. Praying, Lord, that that this summer they will get a break, you know, from the things that go on around the world, Lord. And they go through so much already, Lord. And so I pray for them, Lord. I lift them up to you, Lord. Give them just other things to do for our city, Lord, that they're not so focused on the fires, Lord, but maybe just focused on their community, Lord. And so, Father, again, just if there is any fires, Lord, I pray you go before them. Again, just be their shield, Father. You know, that they can come home to their families as well, as they are the frontline workers, Lord, as they put their lives out there, Lord, not knowing if they're going to come home to their families, Lord. But Father, we know, Lord, that you are with them and you go before them through it all, Lord. And so again, Father, just give us a heart to always be praying for them, not just today, Lord, but beyond this, and not just for this city of fireworkers, Lord, but also beyond this, through the world, Lord. There's so many people out there, so many firefighters, Lord, who put their lives on the line, Lord, for us, Lord, so we can be safe. And so, Lord, again, we just go before you. We thank you, Father, for this opportunity today to pray, to lift up just all the needs of this community, Lord. And so, Father, we love you. We thank you in your most precious holy name, Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Thank you.
As part of our dismissal, maybe 30 years ago, there was a brainchild that came up with an idea that they say that God dropped in their spirit. And it was the chaplains here in Fontana. And I'd like to say thank you to Phil Cothran, because he followed through with it 30 years ago. You know, anything that God has his hand on will prosper and be around and around and around and around and around. We do thank you for coming out today, and for your support, your spiritual support and your natural support. So, Father, we thank you, we bless you for this opportunity once again. And we ask that you go with us as we leave here, Father. Abide with us, guide our footsteps, guide our hearts and our minds. And we'll fail not to keep you first. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.